So welcome to Tech Talk Thursday, Season 5, Episode 7. SEMICON West in San Francisco is just around the corner, and at this year's show, COMET PCT will launch their latest RF generator platform. It's called Synertia, and here to talk about it is the president of COMET PCT, Michael Kammerer. Welcome, Michael.
Thank you, Trevor,
for giving
me the opportunity for that interview.
Yes, it's good to see you again. So, you know, we've had a pretty rough ride for the last couple of years with all sorts of different supply chain shocks and problems throughout the industry. I mean, how has COMET's business done over the past years through the COVID situation?
So far, so good. So especially the PCT business went quite well, or I would say well. We continued to gain market shares in the last years and maintained our place as market leader in both of these subsystem spaces, matchboxes and vacuum capacitors. Mm-hmm. We also opened a new volume manufacturing site in Penang, Malaysia,
right. And
a new sales office in Taiwan. Okay. COMET gained new customers and double-digit design wins every year.
Right. That's interesting. So is the majority of your business over in the Asia market, or is it spread more evenly?
The main customers are sitting in the US, but 80% of our products go to the Asian market finally.
Yeah.
So this is why we also choose Penang to be close to the Asian market.
Yeah, that makes sense. So COMET's known as the expert in both vacuum capacitors and matching networks. How are you performing within these markets lately?
So we are the market leader in both of these markets with these products.
Mm-hmm.
And saw a year-over-year single-digit market share growth from 36 to 39% in matching networks. We wanted to reach the 40%, but unfortunately we landed at 39 point something. But I'm sure next year we will be over 40.
Well, I think in the conditions, any growth is welcome, that's for sure. COMET has some presence in the generator space. How will this new platform expand your services available in these markets?
So that will definitely open a huge opportunity. Our SAM will grow from about 500-600 million to 1.5 or 1.7 billion with having this generator, and then in combination also with the matchbox and the new matchbox technology, what we also been developed, by the way. It's not only the generator, it's also a new matchbox control, right. And that is then going together to the market, right. Finally.
Okay. Well, that's going to be quite a significant jump for you then. So the generator system is called Synertia. And you describe it as a power delivery platform. So what synergies are enabled across the generators and matches and vacuum capacitors?
So it's a superior plasma measurement and control at the sub microsecond level.
Right.
Let me say it's one and one will result in three. That is finally what we're going to do to target and achieve. And thanks to the vertical integration of the single sub components, this is all in our hands. And we can do with all these subcomponents the final design out of our hands. We don't have to buy the critical components to do the final design.
During the development of the platform, what new tools and techniques were developed and deployed, and how did they impact the process?
First of all, for being able to design a modern product platform, we invested in a cutting-edge development environment. So we expanded the lab space. We built a smart lab, so-called smart lab. And this is just a closed loop environment to develop the new RF generator and also the new RF matchbox technology.
And where is that located?
That is located in Switzerland.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But we will duplicate the smart labs to other R&D locations like San Jose in the Silicon Valley, yeah. like Aachen in Germany. That's that's the production place, mainly the production place for our new generator. And we will also duplicate it later to further design locations of PCT.
Okay, good. So the design co-optimization is a key point of discussion throughout the value chain these days. Can you expand on a couple of the new platform capabilities that facilitate this co-optimization for OEMs and the possibly for the fabs as well?
Absolutely. The focus lies on advanced data visualizing by helping of an adaptive graphical user interface, a GUI. So that will be a very user-friendly GUI. So you really, I just saw it yesterday. You really want to touch it. You want to start to play with. So that's a very user-friendly GUI. And for example, it includes advanced oscilloscope functions for direct access to crucial process parameters.
Okay, that's useful.
So it's just an example.
Yeah, absolutely. Can you elaborate then on the target markets or applications that Synertia is focused on?
That are the leading applications in etch and deposition, including ALD and ALE processes.
Okay. So what new capabilities will Synertia then bring to the process challenges within these applications?
Multi-level pulsing with wave shaping.
Mm-hmm.
Customizable frequency tuning and advanced plasma analytics.
Okay, so that's quite a lot. What impact will these new capabilities have on the IC making process?
That's pretty simple. It will improve the device yield, mm-hmm. true output, and accelerate the time to money for our customers.
Right, great. Now, ESG, of course, is a big topic across the semiconductor manufacturing sector, not just the semiconductor side, but how is Synertia addressing these concerns?
So we have a better AC to RF conversion efficiency and lower water usage. That results in lower footprint and lower total cost of ownership for our customers and for the environment, of course.
Okay. So I know that we've got a big launch plan for SEMICON West, which is coming up next month. When will the Synertia platform be available for initial process qualification?
It's already available. We already delivered some beta 1 versions to customers for initial testings.
Right.
We are now in production for the beta 2 versions. And the beta 2 versions will start to be spread out around July. Then we will serve further customers, and the existing beta 1 customers will get a beta 2 version. And the beta 2 version is very, very close, if not already finished, to the final version.
The final one. Okay.
Of the final one, we will go in H volume in beginning of next year, January.
Right. So you're looking at really by the end of the year, you should be ready to sort of move into
absolutely.
High volume. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's certainly a very exciting development for COMET, Michael. I want to wish you every success with it. And I want to thank you for coming in and telling us about it today.
Thank you very much to you, Trevor. And again, thank you very much for giving me and COMET this opportunity. It's always great to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ko Young is leading a smart revolution that will change the world of electronics manufacturing. Based on our pioneering True 3D measurement-based inspection technology, we revolutionize the solder paste inspection market to such great lengths that 1 in 2 SPIs sold today is from Ko Young. Building our SPI technology, we expanded to automated optical inspection, also known as AOI. Every year, we introduce new award-winning innovations and have proudly earned the respect from thousands of customers across diverse industries. Aside from our R&D center in Korea, we have research facilities focused on artificial intelligence and deep learning across the world to help us further develop proprietary AI technologies for your challenges. With our global network of sales and service centers, we aim to respond quickly to your needs and to deliver the highest level of customer satisfaction.